Hey, this is Full Game Prometheus giving you another full game recap. Once again, I'm going to be rolling with the Arizona Cardinals as my offense. Matt Patricia, Detroit Lions as my defense, using a lot of 43 defense. I'm going to be going against the Jets this time. Not a very common team to see online ranked. Guy must be from New York, big Jets fan to be rolling with a team like this. So I went ahead and started making adjustments. I decided to go ahead and get away from the yellow zones and actually use deep quarters with my safety blitz for our coverage. So if you can see, these guys will actually drop down and then actually play the run and actually come out. And right from the very beginning, I get a nice little interception. He throws a little out route with Khalil Mack, and I'm able to go ahead and get the ball right into the end zone on the first play of the game. So that's really good. He actually does a little play action thing, throws right into my three hook zone with my defensive tackle, tries to run the ball. This defense was just blowing up his running game. He had no running game whatsoever. I come into the nickel defense right here, try to set up the blitz. He's blocking a bunch of guys. I actually press and actually finds a nice little slant route. So this guy liked to run a lot of slant routes as some of his primary routes on offense, and it took me a while before I started closing it up. He actually got away with some different types of plays. But right here, he throws the ball up into double coverage. He's able to go ahead and come down with it with a nice big grab with his wide receiver. He get himself a first and 10 down in a 33-yard line, but no going with the running game. It was just completely shut down with this Bears front, and especially the way I was running this defense is bringing my safeties down, even though they were playing deep quarters. He tries to go ahead and run the ball once again, and I'm able to go and bottle it up with that deep front. And I come into just a basic nickel blitz right here and try to go ahead manually blitz myself off the edge, and my linebacker Floyd's able to clean it up. And look at this guy. This guy's kicking a field goal from 39 yards away, which essentially is a 56-yarder, and he actually connects and gets a three-point conversion. So I was surprised he tried to kick a field goal. This guy obviously probably practices a field goal a lot because that was what he was doing. So right there, I want to show you something. This guy was using a lot of man blitzes against me initially. I almost threw right into a spy right there. I think the guy spied up right there. So I noticed he went another man blitz. So what I did is I jumped into a double move. He went with Sluggo. And basically what I'm going to do is just watch that safety on the inside of Robinson. And if he goes away or comes down into the front, see how he drops down? He's not playing that coverage, he's playing over the top. I'm able to go and pop Robinson by hitting the turbo and actually go ahead and take him in for a one-play touchdown with Sluggo. So if you've got a guy that runs a lot of man blitzes against you, it's easy to pop him for a one-play touchdown, get him out of the defense, and I guarantee you he did not run a lot of man defense after that play. I'm going to pay the price on that. So goes back to flat again. I'm able to go ahead and get a pass deflection. Still staying with this cover four type shell. No running room right there. Third and 10 type of situation. Now I come into the nickel blitz to try to go ahead and hit him with the blitz, trying to set it up right here. Press my coverage, and I'm actually supposed to look right there. I totally missed it. I didn't get the right angle on it, but he's able to go ahead. He did a streak slant on the backhand side, and he was able to go and do this. So I think he might have no-huddled. I'm on with the same play again. It gets a little play action animation and actually hits me right down the middle and takes off with his wide receiver to go ahead and get the ball in the end zone. So I was spamming that nickel blitz, and the way he was running his offense, where the holes of that blitz was at. So it wasn't necessarily a good play call for me to keep going back at it. I was spamming it, and it wasn't smart. Look at Tariq Cohen actually breaking some tackles right here. He actually almost won house. I come back to the play right here, and look at the guy is. I go ahead and check it down to the tight end. Actually came with a heavy man blitz, being able to go and get a first down. Go back into angle smash, and the corner route is wide open, and I get a poor animation to get ran out of bounds. I probably could have took that house. We'll go back to angle smash again, and right here I jump into the dig. play right here, and I'm looking off to the right. It's man coverage, and I go ahead and just hit him right over the middle with the dig route for man coverage for another touchdown. So up 21-10, 3 minutes left in the second quarter. I'm in autopilot right now. All I need to do is get another stop against this guy, and I think this guy's going to actually skunk out of me. And it actually takes another shot up top, but I got a defensive back to go ahead and make a play on the ball and swat that down. Second and 10 situation right here. He's in a shotgun formation. He jumped into a screen. It's actually a really good call, but he doesn't get a good animation. He actually cuts in, so he only picks up 4 yards. So third and 6 situation, once again, staying with the same defense. Actually switch it up and go into cover 2 shell, outright blitz right here with my linebackers. He actually blocks 6 and hits me on the slant again. So this was the area of the field he was attacking me, and I was not covering it at all. Goes in the bunch situation. He actually goes ahead and hits a little wheel route. He's able to go and get himself 8 yards right here, come back into a cover 3 shell. And right here, he takes off this quarterback, and he's able to go ahead and get a first down. So playing pretty smart. No huddles again. I stay with the cover 3 shell. I got guys down in the box. He does a little run, a counter run in the inside. I'm able to go ahead and tackle that for just a 2 yard gainer. Stay with the cover 3. Still giving him the same look and putting everybody down in the box with the strong safety 3 right here. I'm actually trying to take away one of those wheel routes. I send the dogs after him, and he actually runs out of bounds. So he actually loses a couple yards in that. So a third and 10 situation. I go into a man blitz right here. The right read is actually to be on the right hand side so I can get some pressure, but he's able to go and hit a slant once again off the left hand side. So I'm jumping into the man blitzes to try to change things up, but this guy was using a lot of slants, and that essentially was his reads right there. So right here, takes off this quarterback again. I'm able to go and tackle him just for a few yard gainer right there. Second and 6 type of situation, no huddles. I go ahead, set myself up with a cover 3 shell, and I spy up my defensive tackle just to go ahead and take away some of his reads. He does mesh, picks up the running back route. No one's in the flat. He's able to go and pick up a first down. First and 10 situation with 40 seconds left. I cross man my defensive backs and actually go ahead and try to play the middle of the field. He throws right to me, and I miss the interception. That should have been a pickoff right there based on it. Now I'm going back to this nickel blitz again. I'm like determined to go ahead and get this nickel blitz to work against this guy. Put a QB yellow right there, and actually runs the ball. My defenders are out there to go ahead and bottle it up. Third and 5 situation. Now I think I jumped in cover 6, and I spied up my guy and actually threw right into the spy. And what he does is smartly settle for 3 points. This guy actually, he didn't really have the best game, and he was playing with an inferior team, but he did make good decisions by actually settling for points and putting him in a situation where he can actually go ahead and penalize it. And right here, I get a nice little spoon move with an off-tackle stretch play out of the single back ace, and Cohen is just off to the races, and I'm able to go and get a touchdown on the first play of the second half. So I'm in the autopilot right now. I'm actually up by 2 good possessions. He's in a bind right now. He has to get a 2-point conversion and 2 touchdowns to get back into the game. Takes off with Donald, able to go and pick up a first down right there. Nice run by him. So once again, I'm playing this cover 4 shell. I got my guys in seam flats. He throws to the flat. I didn't play a hard flat, so that's why that was wide open. So he picks up another first down, no huddles again. Goes into cover. I jump into cover 3 and spy up my defensive end just to go ahead and try to contain his quarterback. Right here, he hits a little angle route, but I think he drops the pass right there. So second and 10 situation. He's back into, it looks like double, single back doubles right here. I go ahead and play this cover 4 shell. He's doing slants, and he actually hits this guy to the out of bounds right there. So third and 4 situation. He's going into, it looks like a single back formation again. I try to get him with some more pressure. He's a little drag route, and my defensive back does not tackle him right there, and I give up a first down. First and 10, once again, going with the cover 4 shell. He tries running. I'm actually just no doing any kind of running after with that particular play. Go into a cover 2, I spy up my defensive tackle just to go and take away his scrambling capability. He actually checks it down to flat, but I have a defensive back out there that go and tackle him for only a 3 yard gainer. Now I come back to this nickel blitz again, the Overlord 3, just trying to go ahead and get this guy just to take one. But right here actually throws into coverage. My guy does not come down with it, and he's going to go ahead and try to go ahead and kick another big long field goal, which is about 53 yards, but he doinks it off the eye, off the beam, and he misses it. So now I got the ball back, up 21-13. I go with flanker drive right here, and this is probably one of the play of the game for him defensively. He actually just users me with a sack right there and takes a big sack with his user right there and actually puts me in a bind. So I come into angle smash and basically hit the running back route. I'm able to go and pick up a good chunk of those yards back. I think I get it down to a 3rd and 18. And right here I come to the play action, roll out, and my guy just completely overthrows the ball. That could have been a first down and more if I would complete it. But the smart thing to do right now is just put this guy back on offense. Don't give him a short field. Make him earn his drive all the way down the field, because he really hasn't had a lot of success on offense for except a few plays. Get a little block shed right there. I'm able to go ahead and get a tackle him for a sack. So 2nd and 17 right here. I go with a sting blitz, man blitz, and he actually just hits me another one of these crossers. I was actually in the area, but I had a hard time with it. So go back into cover three right now. Spy up my other defensive end off the left-hand side right here, and he actually throws it perfectly in the seam. That was a good play. That was actually a good throw right in the seam. I go ahead and I change it up. Go into cover four, but I put two yellows over the middle. Guys actually go here and hit stick them. 2nd and 10 situation. I bring everybody down, staying with this cover four, go with hard flats to take away his read, and actually spy up my defensive tackle just to go ahead and play that. Play if he actually takes off, and he does. I go ahead and send the dogs after him, and he actually throws the ball smartly away. So 3rd and 10 situation, he's in bunch. I decide to go ahead and put yellow zones in the middle, take away some any inside reads. He actually goes ahead and catches the ball and gets into a 4th and 7 situation. Guess what I go back to? Go back to the nickel blitz this time, and basically go ahead and put a flat on the left-hand side. Yellow zone. I'm trying to get some pressure off here. He actually does not block. I do not get the read right there, but he actually runs with his running back. He puts him on a wheel route, and I tackle him short and get the ball back. So now I'm back in the driver's seat. Go back into the ace formation with a little stretch play. Get some pretty good animation and go ahead and pick up a first down. He burns a timeout, trying to keep himself in the game. Now right here, I come into the corner flats. It actually goes ahead and does another user blitz against me, and he gets me in a bind. So I jump into corner strike out of the trips formation, streak up my tight end, put my wide receiver off the left-hand side. Tight end's wide open. I go ahead and hit him, but I get hit stick, and he drops the ball. So I'm like, I bet you this guy's going to run the same defense again. So I'm going to run the same play. But this time I'm going to go ahead and possession catch that pass. Throw the ball a little bit earlier and possession catch that pass right there with the tight end. So that's what I did, and I actually got myself down. He actually takes another timeout. 4th and 2 right here, and he's got his line all scrunched up to the middle. So I just do a little inside zone, but my goal is just to run to the outside. He actually misses me on the tackle and able to go and get a first down right there. And one more play in the game right here. I just do a little stretch play off to the left-hand side, get pretty good blocking right here, and Tariq Cohen is right off to the races, and that's about it for this guy. This is all I can handle. So once again, guys, using the Arizona playbook, I got myself another win, and my defense out of the 43. So my subscribers, thank you for your support. Until next time.